So my wife is moving her classroom home again. Still got Sophie's stuff up there. Haven't got to this because I'm just demotivated. Almost done with the deck, so that's gonna free up some wood space and I can collapse all this. But yeah, this is going in the basement this fall, all this wood. My car's coming out one way or another. I don't know what she's gonna do with all this crap, and there's more. Yeah, I just got the back end done.
Okay, I got it, man. Those are some pretty spiffy Union Jack tail lights on that Mini Cooper.
But when I bought this car last fall, it was clearly leaking oil onto the manifold. This rainbow. And so I subsequently ordered a new valve cover gasket because they get hard after a decade or so, or 20 years in this case. 25. Some number. But anyhow, I did it. I torqued it all the factory specs, and it was still leaking. So I thought, you know, it's going to burn off. So like 6 months later, it's still burning off. I did check the oil. There's plenty of oil in there. Definitely got enough blinker fluid, but a little low on the radiator thing there. But there's the air pump that makes a fucking lot of noise. That should be a delete, but that's another topic. So anyhow, after checking the oil and figuring out where to put the disc back, this is still COVID brain, I decided to recheck all the bolts, and sure enough, this guy, enhance, right, where is she? Right, she's down there, she's down there, she's right there. That one was actually loose, so I tightened on that. 10 newton meters, which is not a lot of force. It's got like you'd finger wrestle more force. So hopefully she has a leak. So then I sprayed it down some engine clean, trying to get in that general area on the exhaust, and washed it and got some rainbows. So we'll see. So I definitely got to pick up some radiator fluid, keep the radiator fluid ended, and still got to fix the door and wash and wax it. But for now, she's fixed. Done. L completed.
August 1st. We were hoping July 1st, but yeah, yeah, August now.
What you eating, pretty bird?
That's awesome.
Yeah, thanks.
It's so beautiful. And I can't wait to see it. Like Kayla's doing wonderful too.
Get yourself a walking taco?
She's.
Note the lack of sausages on my sausage pizza.
Supposed to rain today, but right now it's blue skies, sunny. So yeah, we're gonna start this second to last row. So got my piece, gonna put my piece in now. Because I can't use my biscuits on the other side, I'm gonna be screwing in. So I'll be using that drill bit to make a pilot hole, then this to make a square hole, then I got little wooden plugs, so basically like enhance that, except I gotta find the glue. Those haven't been sanded, so the reason those are different colors because the glue that I used wasn't sanded and it's protected the wood. So this wood was put in last year. It's gonna look totally different when it's oiled. Hopefully, maybe tomorrow if it doesn't rain. Certainly next week. So anyhow, so we're gonna pull this back, screw on every joist, hide them with the plugs. Oh, these are stainless steel Simpson screws. They're very nice lock. Except the stainless steel isn't as strong, so I gotta be a little careful. But they're the Torxies. Then I'm gonna cut the piece and slide it in there. Now, we got this gap issue here, so I'm gonna have enough to put a screw every couple of feet in here. Obviously it's a captive board and people don't walk over here, so it could probably even just float in there. And I'm gonna make it big enough just to float, but I want a little gap. So to keep the gap, I was thinking about getting some stainless steel, like 18 gauges, shoot some nails in there. And I may end up doing that. Over here again, we got the gap. So there's gonna be very little, like a 16th of an inch showing here. So, but I'll be able to slide that piece in back here. But I do want a contiguous piece along here so that I can screw it in here and screw it in here, and then I don't have to worry about it. Again, it's not gonna go anywhere. I just wanna keep that gap. I want some gap, 1/4 inch, which is way too much, but what all the others are. So hopefully I won't die with sweat out here. So it turns out underneath here, it goes down. This piece is thicker, but about a 16th inch. So I had to groove this out so that now this piece is gonna be able to slide underneath there and then slide back there. So we'll give this a go. And then it's gonna hit right about there, and then the next piece will go all the way down to there. That'll be fun to cut. Okay, a couple things. One is this is a different height, which makes sense because there's aluminum underneath here. I think I'm just gonna leave on it, but something comes in here. So I think I'm gonna shave off a little on that end, on the other side. But just slide in there. Yeah, I think we'll keep the height. Just to keep this flushy. It's dirty. It needs a washer. Yeah, I also noticed they didn't touch up the paint like they were supposed to, and they didn't fill all the holes with caulk that they were supposed to. I did caulk around here. Here, but I know that the window below, they've caulked about halfway and then forgot to finish it. That's caulked. That one looks a lot more caulked. That one's caulked. That one's flush. That one's flush. That one's caulked. So, just caulk that too. Well, now that I'm up here, hey, this light bulb's gonna be a lot easier to change now. Yeah, had a lot of fun putting that up on a ladder. 3 years ago. So, yeah, we got it going. So, I'm a little mystified on this. Where's the water going? So, there is a drain, a plastic drain that comes this way. We don't know how far it goes, but maybe it's picking this up. I don't know. Mysteries of life. Where is the water going? It's flowing. Okay. Down to the last piece. This last one here was hard to put in because I already had the wood in there, so I had to get her in there. But yeah, one more. Very excited. Okay, she's done. So I just have to come back tomorrow, glue and fill the voids, cut the plugs down, sand the perimeter, sand the inside, and oil it. And I haven't checked the weather, but if it's not raining, we'll get on that. She's high. Then, railing time. So a couple times while I was listening today, the receiver just turned off. I guess it's warm enough, it is overheating. So I got backups, and I don't know where I got this one. It's a Sony, but it's got 21 watts per channel. But more importantly, with that gauge right there, that's adding at least 50 watts per channel. I mean, that is like chrome on a pickup truck. And she matches the CD player. Of course, I can't play the CD player because somebody put a 12-inch subwoofer right next to it, so it just goes bounce, 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 and then it skips. But yeah, we're enjoying this one. We hooked up the old Raspberry Pi with the digital hat up there. So we're just listening to some Cure off of Cubose. Yeah, I use French music service. There's one of the better ones. So yeah, again, lights. So my floor is sagging and I bought this post, but I can't turn it, lift the house. So I got this lamb scrap that she's in there. I'm just gonna, you know, just gotta push on this, push on this. Yeah, I'm gonna go up the ladder and screw on that and see if I get this up. It's about an eighth of an inch down, maybe a quarter. So I'm looking at the Duke Cannon supplies at Lowe's. I do like the soaps. I have the soap on a rope, but this, this is tempting. This should last a lifetime. My lips aren't that big. So we're having fun with Georgia, giving her a bath. She's got to go to the vet tomorrow. We did Spike. She's just going all over the place. I don't know what's going on here. Spike doesn't know what to do. He wants to go down the steps, but there's a cat there. You coming down, Spike? I think I better let him know.